how environmental exposure effects go from parents to children and grandchildren and great-grandchildren.
Él es un especialista, el doctor Vandrani se especializa precisamente en eso, en cómo se transmite de padre a hijo, sucesivamente.
So in order to start, you can say
so we are interested to look at the multi-generation effects in Villegas. So right now we are in a position that we need your help to give us information on what is happening. Then, as we said before, here we can go back and look at these epigenetic changes and try, you know, we will assess the exposure chemicals, and then we will put together to see what are the changes are in these children.
Efectivamente, que como especialista en eso, que realmente es recibir el insumo de ustedes que vienen aquí, para entonces ellos tener esos puntos de datos, para entonces ellos poder estudiar si esos cambios genéticos han transcurrido a través de las
generaciones. The purpose of this meeting and our continual work when we get to grant.
El propósito de esta reunión
is to be in dialogue with the community, so you to understand and listen to you what your concerns are, so that we can take those concerns into our research. We have heard the concern that you mentioned before, also when we spoke with the health legislator. So this is of course something that we want to consider. But I have one question to you. Are these conditions diagnosed?
Yes, they are. There's many students that are being treated and medicated. That is why it's sad, because there is really a lot of kids on pills on the schools.
I think that in a recent study, and it was not an official study because it was an incidental finding, there was an ophthalmology clinic recently held for children, and it turns out that our statistics in Puerto Rico are different from Puerto Rico. Here is 4 out of, it's 4 in 1, and Puerto Rico is 3 in 1. So we have a higher incidence of children with home optical problems.
So, just to say, it's of course important for us when we do scientific research that we can track those diseases that are in the population. So there has to be a record of those diseases. So you know, it's good that these concerns are based on
yes. These kinds of disorders are examples of epigenetic disorders. And we will investigate.
Dice que efectivamente este tipo de no es enfermedad, sino condición, ellos han concluido que sí, que es producto de defecto genético.
Before any questions come up about these effect, let me tell you something that, you know, makes you understand how we are looking at. So if you look at the picture over there, this F0 is the generation that is exposed to the, you know, chemical. So this effect can be in the person that is directly exposed to the chemicals during the time of exposure. But at the same time, these effects, if they are even low, if our body is in the process of transformation, then these effects remain as undetected.
Él dice que a pesar de que el paciente cero, por ponerle otro nombre, está recibiendo los insultos, ¿no? Está siendo infectado o está contaminado, es posible que no se reflejen necesariamente en esa generación porque pasan en estado durmiente.
If you look at these F1 and F2, our children and grandchildren, they have breakout. It means they are not heavily affected, and you know, these effects may not be detected in these two generations. But if you look at F3 and F4 with red color on their body, it means these effects may show up as multiple diseases.
Tal vez en la primera generación no se refleje algún tipo de condición y es posible que la segunda generación tampoco, pero ya en una tercera o una cuarta generación sí se hace sentido o se hace presente el defecto que sea.
So to fulfill our aim, we need the information from you that when exactly, you know, what time, and if you have any additional information on your, you know, when you were here, or what time, you know, you think that was sensitive in your life, and what is your history in, you know, family history of health, that will give us enough information to actually evaluate all our research outputs and connect that with your health.